Yeah. So that's why even in the this is super power country, and you see in the elevator when you, that number it jumps. And do you understand? What's wrong with this number? Unlucky number. Poor number. Miskin. Allah musta'an. So here the Prophet is saying, La hadwa, no contagion, without God's permission. If Allah doesn't want this disease to spread, it will not spread, right? But there are contagious diseases, no doubt. And Islam does not deny that. Does not deny that. That's why when the Prophet ﷺ said there is no contagion, a Bedouin said to the Prophet ﷺ, but O Prophet of Allah, a sick camel mixes with the flock or a herd of camels which they are healthy, and all of them they become sick. And he are saying there is no contagion. The Prophet ﷺ said, but where did he get it, the first camel? Where did he get the disease from? The answer? From Allah. Understand? The first one, where did he get that disease from? The answer from Allah. So the Prophet ﷺ here, he agreed with the man that if a sick animal mixes with animals that they are healthy, they will get sick. He agreed with that. That's why he kept quiet. But he wanted him to believe that the disease and the sickness came from Allah. Are you following? This virus, where did it come from? From Allah. The SARS, where did it come from? Who created it? And these are soldiers of Allah. Something minute, creature, microscopic, keeps the whole world on their toes. To show what? The weakness of the humanity and the mankind. So Allah is teaching us. I can finish you with something you can't see. Something you cannot see it with your eyes will finish you. But I'm only giving you a chance. Don't think that you can do whatever and mess around in my kingdom. But I am patient. These are reminders, messages. Are you following? Do you understand? These are soldiers of Allah. You know Allah. Just one virus. See the bird flu, what is doing? Something you cannot see. The SARS. And every time, something new. These are reminders, signals, messages. Earthquakes, volcanoes, tsunamis. Signals from Allah to ask us to turn to Him. Repent. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, his caliphate, his reign, there was a minor earthquake in Medina. Minor earthquake happened. Immediately he called the Sahaba to the masjid and he addressed the Sahaba. You know what he said? Do you know what did he say? Subhanallah. He said, Ahdathum, you started to sin? He asked the Sahaba, you started to disobey Allah? by Allah, if it happens again, I know how to discipline you. I know how to handle you guys. I will show you something. I will treat you well. Umar is threatening the Sahaba. Because Umar radiallahu anhu realized that this is a signal from Allah. So something must have happened. So that's why he called them. Said, you started to disobey Allah. You started to sin. That's why we had this minor earthquake. This is how the mu'min looks to all these phenomena. We don't ignore these things. These things are messages, signals, reminders from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The believer will wake up. The disbeliever, he doesn't see it. He's blind, he doesn't see. What he knows, his knowledge is superficial. So he will just give you a physical explanation. The other dimension, he doesn't see it. Because he doesn't believe there is a creator in the first place. So he doesn't see the other dimension behind it. Are you following? Do you understand? Yeah, he doesn't see it. For instance, if you ask any scientist who is not a believer, why do the icebergs float? Or why does the iceberg float? He will tell you because the different density, right? Specific gravity of ice is less than the specific gravity of water, different densities, so the lighter will float. Period. Full stop. Understand? The Muslim will say, Subhanallah. Indeed, he is the protector. Imagine that the ice or the iceberg's density is greater than the water. What will happen? It will sink. So what will happen? Archimedes' principle. Right? The same amount, the same mass of water will be displayed. Right? What will happen to the waves? Will increase. What will happen to the lowlands? Will come under water. What will happen to the fish? Will be crushed, will be killed. So the Muslim saying, Subhanallah, glory be to you, the all wise, the protector. You protected the fish, the ice on top, the water below, and the fish swimming peacefully. They understand? So the perception, the perspective, the believer looks, and the non-believers is entirely different. So we live in this planet, on this planet, and we know there is a creator. That's why when we have a lunar or solar eclipse, what do? We run to the masajids and we beg Allah, forgive us, sorry. We are sorry, forgive us, oh Allah. Not because we are superstitious and we don't know the scientific explanations. But we know something behind that. And even the law of the gravitational pull. Force equal what? K M1 into M2 over D square, right? True or not? What will happen if the moon remained in that position? What will happen to the force, the gravitational force? What will happen? It will multiply. It will be a tremendous force. So what will happen to the water? There will be tidal waves, right? A lot of damage will happen. So we cry to Allah, please, oh Allah, let the moon carry moving. Because everything is in his hand, right? So always, the mu'min, the believer, when he sees these signs, the way you perceive them is totally different from the interpretation of the non-believer. Because he's blind, he doesn't see what is behind. So, a Muslim studying chemistry, physics, biology, anything that increases his iman. This increases iman. Why? Because he sees this, the signs of Allah. They call them the law of physics or natural laws. These are divine laws set by Allah. Allah set these rules and laws.